Hello students. So today is an important video because today I'm going to discuss only the strategies of the two examination which are going to appear in the next 1 month. Number one is ISDI, number two is NID. Yes, we do have to give IID examination as well in between, but the IID exam pattern is still not out. But generally they have their written examination and a group activity. They don't see the portfolio. So for ISDI, the type of preparation you need to do is that, see, their paper is going to be a innovative paper. What it means by innovative paper is that innovative paper, no one can predict what all content is going to be in the paper, but it's going to be, I guess, 1.5 hour paper. And the weightage of paper, I don't think it's more than 30% or 25%, but the major is your, not, I won't call it portfolio, because portfolio is that what artworks you have done, but it's more kind of conversation with the interviewer, in which they want to see what else you have done in last 3-4 years, which includes the artwork. Artwork is just a part of that. So apart from that, please do carry the, if you have designed a wedding card or greeting card for your sister or your friend, do add that. You can add the school certificates of elocution, debate. If you have written some kind of poem, just type it and take the printout. If you have done the wall paint, just click it and show it in a PowerPoint presentation format. You can show the things in your laptop, in your tab or in your mobile. But just make sure you are not showing only the drawings and artwork. They are not, they don't get impressed only by the drawing and the artwork. So don't get confused. I mean, I'm getting so many inquiries from you guys. See, if the portfolio would have been so important, I would have definitely get it done. But they don't ask for portfolio. I don't understand why you people are not getting that. They don't want to see artworks. They want to see all kind of extracurricular thing apart from artwork. See, if you are, if they have received the form from design circle, it automatically means that you are working on your artwork. So why to show that again? No need to show the artworks again, but yes, couple of artworks you can show which shows your interest. Suppose you are a communication design student, I mean, you have applied for communication design, show them some posters, some magazine covers you have designed, or in your school you have done a magazine, you have participated, your name has come in the newspaper, show them. If you have done a product, then you can show them the artificial jewelry you have designed. You might be, you might have designed a shoe on the paper, whatever. And if you have, if you have nothing at all, then show the file you are doing it design cycle, to show that it's not a new it's a new thing for me, and I have decided this in the last month only or last couple of months that I want to get into the field of design and have started preparing. So show whatever you have without getting nervous. At the end of the day, my letter of recommendation, my recommendation also carries a lot of weightage. So they will surely ask me, see, if you fail to show anything, they will surely ask me that they will ask me about you. So I'll speak about you that, okay, she's good in this and you should definitely. So please don't worry much about ISD examination, and it's a good practice before an ID examination, because NID is also going to be a experimental paper. So let's discuss about the NID paper and strategy. So now we are sitting on the 3rd of December and the NID paper is on the 29th of December. So I have written, I have all the points which I have to discuss. First of all, about the NID examination. 2019, like this year, the examination what they have taken was like for the 2018 students who have appeared for the exam in 2019, 5th of January. So they have asked 70, the paper was divided in two parts. First section was 30%, second section was the 70% weightage. So first of all, you should understand that the written examination total weightage is 30% and the next round of examination total weightage is 70%. So if you clear the first round of examination, they will convert whatever marks you have secured in 30% and the next round will be 70%. That is called the studio test, and that is going to happen in the first week of May. When it comes to studio test, we are going to prepare for all kind of studio questions they have asked so far in the last 10 years. But let's not discuss about the studio test. That's the second stage. First stage is how to clear the written examination. First of all, it's, suppose it's a 100 marks paper, it's not important to secure marks in all the sections. See, all we need is to clear the cutoff. Like this year, the cutoff changes every year. Sometimes it's 50, sometimes it's 52, sometimes it's 60, sometimes it's 45. It depends on the level of difficulty of the paper. So if the paper will be tough, the cutoff will come down. If the paper is easy, the cutoff will be higher. If the paper is lengthy, the cutoff will be again something mid type, 50, 55 or 51 will be the cutoff. You have to understand that in NID examination, each and every point of marks matter. So first of all, decide yourself that you are going to spend 10 minutes on one mark question, or you are going to spend 10 minutes on a 10 mark question. So first of all, pick your priority. Your priority should be that attempt all the questions which has the higher weightage of marks. So suppose you have left 120 marks drawing, your game is over that point of time, because you have left 20 marks, because you spend a lot of time in doing the English or the verbal and non-verbal reasoning section, and you are putting your brain there, because they are very chalu people. What they do in an ID, that the first section will be the theoretical section, and you have a habit of starting from question number one, and you will start from question number one, and you will figure it out. Oh, by the time you have finished the part one, which has the 30% of the weightage, your half or more than half of the time is gone, and oh, you are left with only half the time for the next 70%. It might be possible that this year they again change the pattern and do it the reverse they have done, like 70% theory and 30% drawing, which was the pattern in 2016, 17 and 18 examination. So we have to be ready for all kind of surprises. There is no shortcuts, there is no fixed pattern. When there is no fixed pattern, it means that paper is new for everyone. If there will be NIFT has quite a kind of fixed pattern of examination, their description and their strategy will be different. So that examination in the month of January, we have a lot of time for that to work on our strategy. The best strategy for NIFT is that slow and steady win the race. So you have to be very calm and clear and give the attempt. But in an ID, you can't be slow and steady. You have to attempt as many questions as you can in a short duration of time. So you have to ensure, first of all, that you have attempted all the questions you know. What does it mean that all the questions you know? That suppose there is a post, like last year there was a question that design a stamp. It was an easy question, but trust me, that was the second last question, and most of the students failed to even reach to that question because they have spent a lot of time, because they were a habit, they had the conception in mind that there will be around 70% theoretical section, 30% drawing, and it completely reversed. So this year it might be possible that they completely reverse the pattern, and they might do 50-50, or they might give you 100% of the theoretical section and zero drawing. We don't know anything about the pattern. So the best way to prepare for an ID is that be ready for any kind of pattern. Don't get nervous at the point of examination. Which kind of pattern is this? I'm not prepared. Trust me, no one is prepared for an ID. If any coaching center claims that we know the pattern, it means that they are lying. The same way I'm also saying that we don't know the pattern for an ID. All we know that we have done most of the syllabus thing. We know, you know the basics. And secondly, this paper is creative. Don't make it artistic. So what you do, many of you I have seen that, if a question comes that draw a scene of a villa scene. Villa scene for NIFT will be different, obviously, because villa scene for NIFT you will get 40-45 minutes, and villa scene for NID won't get more than 20 minutes. But what you do, you start doing the same thing which you have planned it for NIFT. See, for NIFT you can add a lot of element, but for NID you have to be strong enough that okay, these are the five main elements which I can do it in 10 minutes. So only add those elements which are extremely important for that examination. Don't do the things what you have prepared for NIFT. That is a separate examination, separate preparation. NID is a separate examination, separate preparation. In the same way, UCT also, they have introduced drawing this time. We don't know which kind of drawing they will ask. Only one question they have asked, only one question, two questions, we don't know. So again, coming back to NID, so first of all, you have to understand that you don't have to get into extreme detailing, because if you get into extreme detailing in one question, you might leave the other. So it's a good idea to secure 3 out of 5, 4 out of 5 in every question, rather than to attempt 5 out of 5 in one question and you get 0 out of 10 in the other question. So first of all, ensure that you are getting some or the other marks in each and every question, then only we have a chance to get into an ID. The only way to get into an ID is that you have seen the question number 1 to last, and you have attempted all the question you are confident about. You have left all the question you are not confident about. It might be possible that you see, oh, I am leaving so many questions. So it means that the paper is tough. And if the paper is tough, you are supposed to leave the question. But I am sure that there will be around 60% of the question which is going to be easy. But then you have to find it out in which area, in which section it's lying in the paper. But if you leave last three pages, it might be possible that you have left the best of the easiest of the three pages. Okay, so don't waste time for the NID. So the type of paper, I told you that the section can be 70-30, 30-70, 50-50, any kind of combination. Then second is type of drawing. So type of drawing is something in NID is we cannot guess. Like we have seen the most common questions which they give is logo design. They have also given many a times we have seen that they have given you a picture and they have asked that which artist has drawn this picture. So what you need to do, first of all, go through all the major paintings of the world, Van Gogh, I mean whichever painter has made, because they might ask you a question that first of all identify the painting, and then they might say you that add the elements in that painting to show a scene of destruction. So you have to be ready with those kind of questions. They might give you a half filled and half empty artwork, and they will say ki now you have to, like they can give you a half office is totally drawn on the sheet, and they will say the rest half you have to draw keeping in mind the theme Ayurveda. Okay, so you have to draw that thing. So many a times we have seen that they might also give you some kind of logos that okay, this is the logo, now you have to redesign the same logo with this thing in mind. So few years back there were question like this is a logo for the old age people's company. So now now the product is also being offered to the teenage and the young group. So now add the colors and change the shape so that it also reflects that this company also serves the kids and the teenage. So so this is another type of question. I hope you have done it. See, there is no coaching even for these kind of question, because these all are basic question. All you need to understand that if it's for kids, these colors will be added, this shape can be added. So if your basics are strong, NID paper is extremely easy. Then they also give you sometimes that okay, they have four boxes. In four boxes they have drawn some kind of random lines, and now they will ask you to finish the drawing, and so you have to add things on that lines and make a product or make a composition type of thing. So lines, because NID loves lines, shapes, cuboids, rectangles. So they, many times we have seen they have given a question based on these topics. So this is one thing also. Then they also give you, I told you that they will give you artwork, and they will tell you to fill the artwork with some kind of theme. They might give you a urban scene, the scene of an urban place, and they might ask you to add elements so that it becomes a village scene, something like it. Then they might they also love a lot about proportion, perspective, not perspective as much, but proportion a lot. Ki, like I have 100 of question in mind which I can tell you right now. They have given that okay, this is a room, now draw a human, a cat, a dog, a chair, a TV in proportion. They might give you a question that draw a human and cat in the same proportion, but enhance the table 400 times of its current size. So you have to design a formula. What you people do that you start, see, it's the solution is not to make the a chair big, but the solution is that make the human in proportion of the chair so that the chair looks big. What point? So what you do, so whenever you get a question to enhance or to enlarge the product, you enlarge the product. That doesn't mean that it has enlarged for 20 times or 30 times. To enlarge anything, you have to make something in the proportion of that thing to make sure that okay, this has been enlarged. So many times we have seen that they have given the question for proportion. One year I still remember they have given a question that the draw a human and draw a cat and reverse the proportion. So it means that the cat has to be a human size and a human should look small. They have given that take out 5 or 10 different kind of uses of sharpener in the first drawing, enlarge it for 10 times. In second question, enlarge it for 20 times. And few of you, what you have done, you have just enlarged the thing in all the boxes. You have not shown anything in proportion to ensure that okay, the enlargement is valid. You have to be good with the heights. So if you have to keep in mind the height of human, the height of chair, the height of street light, the height of building. If a building is for 4 floors high. So what will be the size of the building in proportion with human figure? So in the last 20-25 days, work on the proportions. Go out, see the traffic, see if it's a truck. If it's a truck and a human is standing in front of truck, how small or how big the truck is looking, or how small the human is looking in front of the truck. And if that truck is standing in front of the building, how small or how big the building is looking, or the truck is looking, how much small. So if you keep all these proportions in mind, definitely the paper will become easier for you, because NID paper is a lot about proportions, is a lot about the measurement which is in your mind. So keep all the measurement in mind. Many of you fail to, you make a car and the human look 2 times bigger than the car. So this happens because you have not observed. You have not observed because while traveling on road, you're busy on your mobile phone. You have not seen what's going around. So from at least for next 20 days, go out and see the proportions. Still don't check it on Google. What is the proportion of human in front of a elephant? So you should, you can imagine when you see the elephant and when you see a tree, then you will imagine, a lot of time you have seen on Discovery Channel and different, the elephant standing in front of a tree. So because you know the human in front of a tree and elephant in front of a tree, it will become easier for you to understand how big human will look in front of an elephant. So these kind of proportions you have to keep in mind. Then I told you, they might give you logo identity, which company's logo is this. They might give you one face and give you 4 options, who is he? So who is very important, that you should know the Nobel laureates. That's why when this time I've given you the GK notes for the awards, I've given you the faces also, so that you understand. When you see the face, you will recognize that with faces, but that's not sufficient. But still, I'm trying my best to send you all the important faces of last one decade and the extremely important faces of the history of this country and the world, especially in the field of art. They might give you, they love to give you the question based on recognize this. They might give you a dance form and they will ask you, which dance form is this? They might give you a instrument and they will ask you, which instrument is this? I am trying to send you all these notes, but it's your duty also to figure it out, especially these two sections, who is who? And to see, in the field of recognition, they might give you 3-4 things. First, human, dance forms, animals, like they can give you a bird, which animal is this? Okay, they have given in previous. They might give you a print on sari. They might give you that, which print is this? It's a ikat or it's a chanderi. Which kind of thing is that? It's a bomkai. So they might give you different kind of, but anyways, now don't get panic. I'm sending you all this. We are done with the notes almost. I'm sending you every day. I didn't send you more notes because I've sent you 3-4 notes, and I think first you should go through that, and the next note should be available to you on 5th or 6th of this month. These kind of question doesn't come in the NIFT examination generally to recognize. They are quite clear with the paper, but NID paper can be experimental paper. So but yes, suppose a question comes that recognize this. So if you know it, do it. If you don't know it, leave it. Don't spend 5 minutes and thinking kya hoga, kya hoga, kya hoga, because if you don't know, you don't know. There is no formula of understanding ki, I have seen it in Kathak is like that. So if you don't know Kathak, leave it. No need to spend much time over it, okay? No, because in NID, the important thing is the time management. I'm repeating once and once again, time management. Last year, 32 of my students have cleared the first round of examination. I'm not inflating the numbers, because I'm telling you clearly, 32 of the students have cleared the NID examination. Out of those, around 28 of the students got some or the other center of NIDs. Those students were those who have finished the paper. See, I also take, I also do interact with the students who have cleared the NID examination, that what was your strategy? Because I have given the examination in way back 2005. That time the paper was totally different. Now the paper is totally different. So every year we discuss with the kids that what strategy you followed that you got through. So most of the time the strategy we found they follow is to target finishing the paper. Secondly, not spending more than 5 to 10 minutes in any questions. And secondly, not adding many elements in one drawing, rather than adding quite a number of elements in all the drawings and finishing a tip. Suppose you are not left with any minute, no time, and still you have you are left with a 5 marks question. And think of a creative idea that even there was a student in the last question, it was for 10 marks. 10 marks question for to design a logo for a mobile brand. What he did is that he was left with no time. All he did that he has written the word N, just N, and the mixture of blue and red color. And in the description, he has written that this is a thing of minimalistic approach towards the telecommunication, and he has justified the word N. So point is that if the justification is good, but N shouldn't look like that. It's a waste of. He has not just written N just like that, but proper N. So the point is that, and he has not written N in one corner of the box. He has written N in the center, and that there was a not a smiley but a kind of U-shaped thing, so that it was showing that it's a human face and he's smiling. So he has justified things with this. So the point is that how you are justifying your idea on the paper, that is NID. In NIFT, it's not about how you are justifying the idea on the paper, but in NIFT, it's all about that how you have utilized the maximum time they have given. So in an NIFT, it's not a great thing that you have done the 3 hours paper in 2 hours. No one is going to give you extra marks for that. In fact, they will see that how well you have utilized the time. In NID also, they want to see how well you have utilized the time. But in NID, they are really they are willing to see that how well you have utilized the time, along with how much creativity you have added, because they want to see your ideas. They don't want to see something on the Google and you have drawn the same thing. They want to see how. So if even if your idea is not coming out well, but it's your original idea, that makes much more sense than just doing the thing from your mind, from somewhere else you have taken the idea and putting it on the paper. Even if it's not a problem to put the same thing on the paper which you have seen somewhere, but then do it properly. Okay, now secondly, in the NID paper, they also love to see how you have utilized the space. If the space is a 7x7 box, they want to see how much negative space you have left, how much positive space you have left, how much space you have utilized. It's not a wise idea to utilize the 100% thing, but definitely it's a good idea to utilize the space in a manner that there is a empty space also, there is a positive space also, there is a thing, if it's a poster you have written also, there is a logo also, everything has to be on its own place. So NID, once again, NID is a paper where you will put your ideas in the most creative way, in the most minimalistic way, in the proper time, in the given time, and don't get nervous. NID is a tough paper, we know about it, NID is a tough paper, but that because of the thing in your mind that it's tough, you leave the question. And I don't want to see perfect drawing in two of the question and you left two things empty. So time management is more important than any other thing for an ID. Keep your wristwatch, because you have habit of mobile phone. Open the mobile phone, you see the time, and 90% of you don't wear wristwatch. So it's at exam time, make a habit of wearing the wristwatch early in the morning so that you know the importance of each and every minute in examination. Otherwise, if you don't wear watch, you will be depending on the teacher to tell you that okay, 2 hours is left, 1 hour is left, we are left with 5 minutes. So if you have a wristwatch, you will spend 5 minutes, 10 minutes. I mean, there was a student who used to do with a stopwatch in examination that okay, 10 marks, 10 minutes he started. But I don't recommend you to do this, because nowadays the smartwatch have so many feature, so it might get you for the disqualification. And also a request, don't wear the smart watches on the day of examination. Wear the proper normal and watches with the dial, so that you don't fall in the thing. It might be possible teachers said no, don't wear the smart watch. We have got the we have got the instruction that the students wearing the smartwatch has to keep this, because your smartwatch is no less than the mobile phone these days. So wear the analog watch, proper analog watch, so that you understand the value of time each and every second. And for NID, now the onwards, whatever notes I'm sending, please go through all the notes for the general knowledge. Who is who, whatever thing I'm sending you for NID, I don't think maths is extremely important, but yes, logical reasoning, English, GK and drawing, put your focus on this more than the maths. Maths, I don't think maths is going to be a major topic in NID, but for NIFT, maths is one of the most important thing. I mean, it's for 20 marks, but let's not talk about an IFT for now. Thirdly, fourthly, fifthly. So now in the last 20 days, how to spend your time. So you have pre-boards also. Many of you are having a pre-board examination also. So if you are having a pre-board examination, spend time wisely. Spend your time on for the pre-board also. But yes, whatever drawing you are doing, just do it in 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes. Don't take more than 15, 20 minutes for any kind of drawing. It might be possible that NID gives only 2 questions for drawing this time, 30, 30 marks. Then in that case, we'll spend time accordingly. Whatever I am saying right now is only valid for the things they have asked in past. Whatever they are going to ask in this examination might be totally different than what I am saying in this video. But the first thing I've told you in the video, that is a paper of surprise. When it's paper of surprise, nothing can be valid, whatever I just told you right now. But I hope things will be the same kind of pattern what they have done in the previous years. I mean, 2019, it might be of the same type and same category of the paper. But yes, be ready for any kind of surprise. Paper might be lengthy, paper might be tough, paper might be easy. Just understand which category of paper is this. If it's tough, do the questions which you know. If it's easy, try to attempt as much question as you can. And if it's lengthy, you again try to do as many questions as you can, in keeping the time in mind. So lengthy paper means that a drawing is okay, they have asked to design a spaceship or a thing like to design the outer thing of ISRO, and they have given 10 minutes. So you have to understand that in 10 minutes how you can show the drawing which also shows the ISRO, and it is not looking like any ordinary office. So those elements has to be there. Pick all the elements for the drawing which makes it exclusive and different from the others. So NID is all about how you are different from the others, and to be different, you have to put out the original creative ideas and just don't stick to that I don't know human figure. It's fine if you don't know human figure, make something else. Don't make human figures. If it's a question and they ask you to draw a scene of an office, it's not important that office office at night has no human beings inside it. It will be a closed office. Office is office, whether it's a daytime or it's a nighttime. So take out the ways to prevent the things which help. To prevent the things which you don't know. Okay, so the important is that stay calm, attempt few questions every day. I'm going to send you a lot of sample questions now. And we are going to take the examination for NID, I guess, next week. And we'll discuss the last paper you have given on the same day. We'll return you back the papers, because you have to talk to us about what you have done, what you should. See, when I am taking a paper, trust me, this time around 250 students have appeared for the NID paper I have taken. Around 15, 17 of the students, what they did, that their paper didn't go well. So what they did? They asked me, sir, can I give this paper again? I understood my mistakes. I really want to work on my mistakes and reappear for the paper. And they have reappeared for the paper and they have finished the paper. So the purpose of the paper is not to only tell you that what is a mistake. It's also about how you rectify those mistakes. So we will be taking 3-4 mock tests after 7th of December, after ISD examination. And whenever, if you're giving the paper, do understand, okay, this was the mistake I've done, and I shouldn't have done this mistake, and I'll reappear for the same paper, so that you start clearing these papers. So you will gain confidence, because last paper was tough. Most of you get demoralized. Oh, paper was tough, I didn't manage to clear. So, but none of you asked me. And none of you, why I'm saying, if 15, 16 of the students have asked me, then it means that none of you have asked me that, can I give this paper again with rectifying these problems. So you have to try to reappear only for those. I've given you so many papers. It's time has come to reappear for those papers and see whether you are clearing those papers now or not. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this, and definitely work on the you really need to work on the speed, creativity, and try to show me at least 5-6 questions with all type of time category. 5 minutes, sir, I've attempted this village scene in 5 minutes, I've attempted this village scene in 10 minutes, I've attempted this village scene in 15 minutes, I've attempted this village scene in 20 minutes. So is it fine about all, like the time management? Can you check my time management if I've done the perfect thing for 5 minutes or not? Then we'll help you out. So we are left with hardly 3 weeks of time before an ID examination. The last 3 weeks should be only how to improve from where I'm standing right now. So you have to show me the type of questions you are doing every week. You can send me on WhatsApp, you can send me on mail, but now I prefer that send me on WhatsApp all your attempts so that I can I don't get time to send you the things immediately. And last 3-4 days has been really tragic for me, so I was not coming to office properly because one of my close relative was in hospital, and I really was quite disturbed for that. So it's a request that now I'm here, and I'll try my best to give you feedback as much as I can, and do send me the works you are doing. Just write that you have done it in 5 minutes and what improvement you can do, I'll help you out. And as per GK and logical is concerned, I'm sending a lot of GK, and whatever GK I'm sending you, do read that. Okay, thank you so much. If you have any kind of question, do WhatsApp me. My number is 9971707267. I'm repeating, it's 9971707267. Do WhatsApp me any point of time. If it's at night 2 a.m. also, I'm ready to help you out if you are sending me any kind of work, until unless I have slept. But last 1 month I try to work more harder than you. So whatever help you need from me, I'm always there with you. Thank you so much. Have a great day.